Alright, oh, she's running away. Oh, come here, come here. Well, anyway, so what happened? I tried to install a virtual box on as like an emulator, a second easy, you know, so you can file transfer quite quickly between Linux and Windows, and it was kind of a fail. It's just slow. I can't actually get it to load any of the icons, so it's just kind of a screen freeze. So as cute as the little helper was out there, there was a helper off of YouTube that helped, and he told exact how to install the virtual box on Windows. It was great, his installation instructions, but then my particular version of desktop is not compatible. It just would not accept it. It just keeps crashing. So whether I need more memory or I tried the 64 version and the 32-bit. I'm not having success with either. So darn it. Yeah, and then I'm like, well, okay, fine, I'll do the side-by-side dual. And so I go in there and I'm like, well, okay. I'll be here grabbing these ridiculous, and then it's stating I have to have NTFS. And then I went and I switched one of my favorite singing aria. I can do that. That's something I can do for a living. You all want me to do that? I can put all kinds of your favorite music on a list, so you know where it is. You know what I'm saying? So you can press, you know, song number 32, and then there it is. That type of deal. So I can do that, ordering it, because it's very difficult to order songs on these for some reason. That became a real issue. So yeah, that's a big deal. What else? So I tried to do that. I tried to get these ridiculous to accept. So I didn't accept I tried not the yummy one, but the universal install of the live USB Ubuntu. It did not accept it with the NTFS. Okay, so no. And that was after I went into the BIOS of the cutesy little Windows, and I told it to be the UEFI specifically, and I told it also to disable the security version of it, because it has to have that apparently disabled. In many instances, and also the legacy. So I had to alter all of those, and still nothing. So I'm not really happy with it. And then lastly, I have this one, which is an extension 4. Extension 4 is a no good, I believe so. On an instant input, I think it has to be the FAT32, or the FAT64, or the NTFS. So no, I can't get these to go. So I believe it has to be an alternative version and not the desktop. So I'm not having success with a dual side-by-side boot, which is kind of tedious because you don't actually have access to the files. It's just an operating system that you have to load in this way or load in that way. So it's like just having two computers, but yet on one computer. There's no transferability, so it's not a great, so the emulator's a fail for me, and so I spent maybe 3-4 hours with it this morning, and I'm kind of bummed out, because it loaded so slowly, so precariously, and even just to get the screen, the first front screen, I'm like, this is no good, this is just chugging along, and this is before I even went into the BIOS, so you can't blame me for that one. It was absolutely a beautiful machine, and it just would not accept the virtual box. I'm a little bummed out about it. It seems to be set up exactly to just, that's it. You're stuck with this OS of Windows, and I believe it's a version 8, and that's cool and all. I'm happy for them, but I think it's kind of treacherous to not allow another operating system and easeability there. They did have settings in there in the troubleshooting section. I went in there also to try to change it, and it didn't work so great. It didn't actually comprehend my changes. So it seems to have something that's a lock, and I can't find the lock. You know what I mean? So it's like locked on. Like somebody is just pushing the button saying, no, you are never going to exit Windows. You know what I mean? It just feels like there's somebody out there that's pushing the, what do you call it, the dog food button. You're never going to get out of Windows. And it just, because why? Because I have to fight viral updates daily. I can't stand viral updates daily. It's just... So I'm kind of wincing at this cutesy little machine. I have a beautiful machine. I'll show it to you. It is a Hewlett Packard, and it's cutesy little clamshell for Venus. And so here we are. It's a 413. Is that an error? Are we having a 413 error right now? Oh my gosh. Yeah, so here it goes. You know, it's just a little beautiful little machine. And it's a detachable also. Now, when I say detachable, this is the freak show of it. I'm not sure I needed this requirement, but that's just the way it goes. Life is having it, huh? Oh my goodness, what happened? It's definitely detachable, so now what? Now it's demanding. Now I lost the pretty screen. I'm sorry, I lost the pretty screen. Oh gosh. Bring it back. Oh, now I just have a big keypad there. So I guess you can type in things, but that's not actually what I meant to show it. Now I have to type in the actual password here. Oh my gosh, how terrible. But it's a fun machine. Apparently you're supposed to now take this and watch movies or something, if you're a movie watcher. Oh my gosh, now I'm freaked out because it went this way. I can't handle it. This is just too much happening too quickly. I really didn't need this. I didn't need this fast. No. Oh my gosh. Okay, so I guess if I push there, there it is. That's just like a massive iPod machine, or whatever they call them, Androids or telephone now. Yeah, so it's one of those. And so I'll type in my cutesy little password, and just to get, what do we call it? A screen that has a better image. Because maybe that's really all I'm doing today, because it's been that disastrous. Okay, so there. Now where's the enter? Do you all know where enter is? Oh gosh. I guess so. It could be that one. Yeah. Up there. Welcome. Yeah, I don't know. So now I'm longevity wise. Is that's the length? Oh, I didn't want this way. I didn't want it this way. I wanted it the other way. This is freaking me out. Supposed to now it'd probably be like this, sweep it that way or something. Yeah, they're like, turn it this way, and the whole thing moves. My cousin is so cutesy with her abilities. She knows how to make it fat, and she knows how to make it skinny. Look, oh, see, look at that. All right, it's just like a machine for witches, isn't it? Look at that. It's really cool. It is cool. You have to understand that this is just. Whoever made this, that's fun. Now that's fun. Okay, now, unfortunately, now I'm turned this way and I can't change it, so I'm stuck in Never Never Land. And I'll have to go and look on this computer to find out how do I bring it back to you know, so I have it on this direction rather than that direction. Because that's just terrible. Maybe that's a 413 error. You know, maybe there's a some kind of a secret there. Maybe that is a 413. Yeah, something goes vertical and it's supposed to go horizontal. Yeah, but it's a good one. It's a good little machine. I'm having I don't know. It's a change issue. You know, I was using Windows for years and years and years. I'm not opposed to it. I've had a Hewlett Packard before, but oh yeah, they're really good for graphics. But gosh dang it, that was years and years ago, and I guess I've become like steady with this other version of just Ubuntu. And gosh dang it, now I cannot change it. So maybe that's funny. Yeah, maybe that's funny. Oh well, devices settings and all of this. Okay, so it brings in you see all that on the side, all of these little gadgets. Yeah, I really feel spoiled by this. I didn't actually. I'm absolutely feeling spoiled by it. So I got a Christmas present. I got my birthday present. I got all kinds of things. If I have to state that, all those gifts and those time frames all at once. So anyway, so here it is. It's on a. So that's the remnant of it. So there it just is there, like sad. It's lost its screen. And what else? What else? I don't know. I guess I'm getting tired of checking the email, and the email is like Indeed, Indeed, Indeed. And maybe I've put in the wrong types of jobs to look for, because it just is all this CSS, and all this CSS is just like, I don't know, I don't even have time to do my CSS, my own little, what do we call it, regular CSS. The regular CSS is what? Oh, I put up a favicon yesterday. That was kind of okay. However, it's kind of a bogus favicon. I did not make it a site-specific type of favicon on a JavaScript, so I'm kind of bummed out. I could not find good enough instructions for a JavaScript favicon. Yeah, so the favicon, it looks like it's just going to be a find and replace of the actual image on the server. So in that respect, I just have the code on every page, and so if it says like apple dot PNG, just to have apple.png load on every single page again and again and again and again, you have to just change the image to be also called apple.png when you put up a new image. So you can never have separate image names. And by doing that, that's a workaround it, because I couldn't find really pretty easy JavaScript code. It kept trying to send me off to Varland, and then Varland wasn't working. So I don't know. And there wasn't a document right that I could find that was helpful. So I don't know. That doesn't really make me a JavaScript programmer, but I imagine somebody writes that down on their resume that they're a JavaScript programmer just because of that, because they hunt down for some code and they stick it on a web page. So I'm kind of confused by this whole situation of who's who and what's what. It doesn't seem to be legitimized, easy. And then somebody would say, "Oh, I'm certified," and I certified in what? You know, finding code for a favicon. I mean, I don't know. It just starts to get ridiculous. I just don't understand it. I mean, do you really, really write the JavaScript? You know, because then you're a JavaScript programmer. And so I don't understand any of this. This. You know, you're searching out, and people are looking for CSS admin or CSS writer or HTML person. I just don't get it. I just don't get it. Because at the end game, all it is going to be them, you know, complaining. They don't really like the site that way. They don't want those colors. They don't want the menu on the right. They want the menu on the left. They want it up above. They want it to twirl. You know, they're just going to keep complaining. And then 3 weeks later, they want it changed again. So I really don't understand what the whole process is about anyway. It's just I don't know. I guess it's not really suited for me. The one site that I actually did work on, aside from the family members and my own business, the one site that I really did work on for somebody else, you know, it was just like I did exactly what they said, but then after a while they didn't really like what they said, you know. So they end up in the saying, you know, they say themselves into an alley and they can't get out, and then they're demanding the changes, and because of that, I'm just like, I don't know, I just don't want to be, you know, their demandant, because they made the mistake in the first place. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. It's like when you think about choreography or for ballet or something, or repertoire in a dance, it's like it's already been performed, you know what I mean? And then yet they want to keep going back and changing the choreography. And it's just like, I guess I don't enjoy it. I just don't enjoy it. So I guess that's the way it goes. So that's interesting. Yeah, that's interesting to know about myself, that I would prefer to actually just, that's it, there's your site, and then go have somebody else change it, or you know what I mean? Because after a while it becomes a tedious, like a complaining machine. People are just complaining at you. if with all their disgruntlements, you know. So anyway, very, very cute machine. But yeah, now I've got it stuck on the longe, what do we call it, longitudinal versus the latitudinal. Anyway, so that's the day for the day. Oh, I forgot, it also has a magic mouse. And the magic mouse is phenomenal. It's wireless, and it's just great. He's a great little cutie. And the magic mouse just is, wow, what can I say? Yeah. All right. Yeah, I don't know. What did I put? I put an art director down there on that indeed.com, you know, to bring in the on my emails. I put an art director, and it just keeps bringing up medical institutions. Like they need what? They need people in their gurneys directed around, like some kind of an odd... I don't understand why it keeps bringing up medical. So why is art director and medical on the same page, like again and again and again? So somehow there's something wrong with their search, and they have to put those two, and they really are coming up as art and gallery. So maybe this has something to do with a term they use in the medical establishment. Maybe it's like something to do with the operating room or the operating theater room. I don't know, but it is showing up as a precedent to the art on the wall. You know what I mean? The art on the wall type of gallery and director of that. So I just don't get it. I just don't get it. So that's not working. And well, okay. So yeah. Anyway. I'll try again tomorrow, 11 o'clock, 7 o'clock, 12 o'clock, y'all. Maybe by then I'll flip this up the other side around and not be that way. And, yeah. Cheer up, huh? Cheer up.